Good morning and welcome to the 2021 Memorial Day Ceremony. We're grateful to host this important event. We decided yesterday that due to the threat of rain, we're obviously not at Veterans Plaza. Because of the pandemic, the ongoing pandemic, we're also providing this ceremony virtually. Carmel's Memorial Day Ceremony has become a tradition that shows how proud we are as a city of our veterans and our Veterans Plaza, located in the heart of Carmel, which provides a place where people can come and reflect on the sacrifices that have been made. The patriotic statue of two soldiers, a man and a woman holding a flag, gives us another focus for reflection on our freedoms and the service of others. It is important to pause and remember those that were willing to serve our country and those who lost their lives defending our freedom. I would like to take a moment to give a special thanks to the former Carmel Clay Veterans Memorial Corporation for providing this lasting reminder and tribute to our veterans for Carmel to enjoy for generations to come. Members of the corporation accomplish this important goal by raising donations from the community. But we're here today primarily to remember those who dedicated their lives to preserving freedoms that make America such a great nation. And while we should never take those freedoms for granted, it is even more important during times of conflict to remember why we fight for freedom. Many of us have loved ones serving overseas today, and we must show them our support as well. We will now begin the presentation of the colors with Carmel's own American Legion Post 155 and Veterans of Foreign War Post 10003. When the flags arrive at the stage, the music of the various services will be provided by Cynthia Ensign Bainey. Being presented first, of course, is a flag of the United States of America. The Army flag. Flag. Navy flag. Thank you. Air Force flag. Coast Guard flag. Carmel Police Chaplain for our invocation.
Would you please remain standing?
Under guard.
We'll be having the Pledge of Allegiance.
Regret.
And the National Anthem. Let us pray. Merciful God, we come standing on the shoulders of all who have served the public good. May our honoring of these who place their all before the altar of freedom give them their worthy due. We pray that our recognition of these who gave so much will lift high the virtue of sacrifice, renew our identity of being American, and strengthen the cause of freedom and opportunity for all. Amen.
My God, cover.
Thank you. Now please welcome members from Girl Scout Troop 43-04 and 2638 as they lead the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. It was nice to have you as part of our ceremony. Now please welcome Actors Theater of Indiana founders Cynthia Collins, Don Farrell, and Judy Fitzgerald to perform our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red
beautiful. So pleasure is always to have the Actors Theater of Indiana as part of our Memorial Day ceremony. This time I'd like to introduce our guest speaker, Darren Bebo. Darren was, please be seated. Darren was born and raised in Plattsburgh, New York. He enlisted in the Coast Guard in 1994 with recruit company Delta 144. His first assignment was Coast Guard cutter Spencer Out of Boston. During his time with the Coast Guard, he served as a special operator in the deployable specialized forces, and then was worked with a government contractor all over the world. Darren held a top secret clearance for almost 10 years. He's been on high-risk operations on the high seas in remote areas around the globe, including places, he tells me, he never wants to go back to. He led multiple covert special operation teams, including one responsible for the largest drug seizure in the world. Since then, he has made his transition to the civilian world and now runs and owns successful American manufacturing companies. Today, Darren spends his extra time as a motivational speaker, business consultant, and author. He strives to help others, especially veterans, on their road to professional and personal success. Although his accomplishments are ever-growing, he still manages to share how his life experiences have shaped his career. And I think it's the first time we have had a representative of the Coast Guard give our keynote speech. So that's a first. Please join me in welcoming Darren Bebo.
Legendary General George S. Patton once said, "It is foolish and wrong to mourn the men who died. Rather, we should thank God such men lived." General Patton was absolutely right. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2021 City of Carmel Memorial Day Ceremony, and thank you all for being here. Thank you for having me, Mr. Mayor, and the City of Carmel. We appreciate all you do for our community. As a fellow veteran of the United States Coast Guard, Deployable Specialized Forces, I'm extremely honored to be with you this morning speaking on such an important day. My friend Dan asked me to share with all of you what Memorial Day means to me. Well, I agree with General Patton. To me, quite simply put, Memorial Day is a day not just to remember, but also to celebrate and honor those who are not with us any longer. In my years of service, none of my brothers and sisters ever wanted to be mourned. This is not why we joined the military. I'm proud to have served 8 years active duty honorably. I deployed to many countries around the world, often celebrating Memorial Day on foreign soil, but always remembering why we celebrate this great day. For many Americans, Memorial Day is the start of summer. Cookouts, friends, family, and for many Hoosiers, the Indianapolis 500, which I'm excited to go this weekend with my lovely wife, Jonica, and my friends. It's such a privilege in this country to enjoy these activities, and it's all thanks to our amazing service members. We must remember the sacrifices they have made in honor of our beloved country. I'm not going to stand up here and tell you that we've lost hundreds and hundreds of thousands of soldiers from World War I all the way to the most recent wars in the Middle East, because you already know this. Instead, I want to celebrate those we have lost and inspire everyone here to make an impact. Today, personally, I'm celebrating many people, family members, as well as my former teammate, Nathan Brunkenthal. We celebrate Nate by having fundraisers, golf tournaments, and reunions around the country, keeping his memory alive. A lost family member in any war should never be forgotten. So today is a time to remember those men and women who helped deliver us our freedoms but didn't return home. Today, remember their achievements, their courage, and their dedication. While we have this one day set aside, let us be mindful that we should do this every day. This is what I do. I stand up here with my fellow comrades from the Veterans of Foreign War, VFW, as most of you know it, whom have a mission to foster camaraderie among the United States veterans of overseas conflicts, to serve our veterans, the military, and the communities, and to advocate on behalf of all veterans. An organization that does so much for veterans, but always remembers those who have sacrificed everything for our country. And the American Legion, who enhances the well-being of American veterans, their families, our military, and our communities by their devotion to mutual helpfulness. Can we give these amazing people a round of applause? As Franklin D. Roosevelt said, those who have long enjoyed such privileges as we enjoy forget in time that men have died to win them. The men and women we honor today came from all walks of life, but all shared many fundamental qualities. They possessed courage, pride, determination, selflessness, dedication to duty, and integrity, all of which are essential qualities that are needed to serve a cause larger than oneself, really a true hero in our eyes. This year, Memorial Day looks a little bit different than last year, in the past years. Some ceremonies, parades, and other gatherings have been canceled or are being held virtually due to the current situation around the world. But none of that changes what today means. Today we are enjoying one of life's most treasured moments, spending with family and friends, moments we would not have unless the ultimate sacrifice was given to defend our freedoms. The City of Carmel is a perfect example of a community that honors our history and those who have fought for our freedoms, and for that I'm thankful. We have awarded medals to many soldiers, added their names to monuments, and named buildings after them, all to honor them for their bravery. But nothing can ever replace the hole left behind by a fallen soldier, and no amount of medals can comfort the ones left behind. And for that, we must recognize their sacrifice. As a U.S. Coast Guard veteran, there are too many brothers and sisters who have crossed the bar that I personally know, like my teammate Nate, or a family member you know, a friend, a neighbor, a parent, or the unknown soldier. Please join me in recognizing those among us who have lost a family member to military service. Please stand if you have. We cannot begin to imagine the magnitude of your loss, the sacrifice you have, and continue to endure are a testament to your courage and strength to face such tragedy. Thank you. Today, throughout the country, we are all gathering as a tribute to our lost sailors and soldiers and their families. It is our way to say we remember. It is up to us to keep the memories of their selfless heroes alive. It is up to us to tell their stories and to care for their families who need our support. The men and women who answered freedom's call are remarkable people. So let's be sure we honor them today and every day going forward. We must always remember those who didn't make it home, as well take care of the veterans that did make it home. Help them in any way you can, because they all did whatever they could do to protect you from the evils that are out there. I don't want to leave this ceremony being sad and feeling helpless. I want you to leave here and celebrate this great day and remember the sacrifice that has been given. When you're at the parade or the backyard barbecue, enjoying your family and friends that are with you, celebrate those who can't be here. I know I sure will. Celebrate their sacrifice. Celebrate our freedoms. And celebrate because we live in the best country in the world, the United States of America. You can clap for that. All too often, people hear a speech or leave a ceremony like this and wonder, how do I make a difference? So I want to inspire and challenge each and every one of you today to make an impact. These things don't cost any money and are easy to do. Shall I name a few? Okay, I will. One, you can volunteer at a veterans organization. The VFW and American Legion, they're right up the road. Two, say hello and thank you to a veteran in your neighborhood. Three, listen to their story. And the easiest of all is to fly the American flag in your front yard, and not just on the 4th of July, but every day. Thank you for showing your support to all the men and women and their families who are not able to make it here with us today. Please continue to keep all past and present military members and their families in your thoughts and prayers. Thank you for listening to what Memorial Day means to me. Thank you, and God bless America.
Thank you, Darren Bebo, for your service and for that message. Next, I would like to invite back Actors Theater of Indiana, Cynthia Collins, Don Farrell, and Judy Fitzgerald to sing God Bless America. Cynthia Ensign Bainey will accompany them on the keyboard. Thank you, Actors Theater of Indiana, for that. I was so pleased to hear the introduction sung. It makes one think. I think about Irving Berlin, Russian immigrant, writing that song in the late 1930s as Hitler was starting to take over Europe. I think he saw what was coming, but it was songs like that that helped us and helped tell our story as well, and that was a beautiful rendition of it. Next, I would like to introduce to you Congresswoman Victoria Spartz.
Good morning on this lovely rainy morning, but I'm very happy to be back home in Indiana. Thank you, Mayor Brainerd, for having this great event. We all know freedom is never free, but from the bottom of my heart, on the behalf of the United States Congress, I want to express my deepest gratitude and appreciation to all men and women who paid an ultimate sacrifice. I would also like to thank all current service members and veterans for what you are doing, have done to keep our republic free and strong. May God bless you, your families, and this great United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, I would like to introduce U.S. Army veteran Blair Clark and his students, Gabby Bradley and Marley Bradley, and they will be accompanied by Jeff Reed as they perform My Country, 'Tis of Thee. Thank you. It was very nice. As some of you know, our pianist is Cynthia Anson Beeney. Cindy was honored as a Carmel Clay Teacher of the Year in 2012 has received Carmel's Rangeline Pioneer Award, which is the highest honor a mayor can bestow. She is a former choir director for Carmel Elementary School and is also the daughter of Bill and Dorothy Ensign. Bill, as many of you know, is the former president of the Carmel Clay Veterans Memorial Corporation. And Cindy wrote a song for her father and all veterans entitled Honor. Now please join me in welcoming back Cindy Ensign Bainey and her daughters, Claire Bainey and Lauren Bainey, as they perform her original song.
Oh,
Thank you, Cynthia, Claire, and Lauren. And now, Blair Clark students Claire McGuire and Rosie Winchester will sing America the Beautiful. Sing that a cappella, it's beautiful. Thank you very much. To close our ceremony this morning, Pastor George Davis will provide the benediction. After the benediction, the Carmel Fire Department Honor Guard Pipe and Drum Band and the Indianapolis Public Safety Pipe Band will perform Amazing Grace. Finally, David Bechtel, a member of the Sons of the American Legion, will play taps. As you leave, feel free to take a carnation and place it at the base of the Veterans Plaza across the street. The carnations will be available at this building's northwest exit door. Also, please take a poppy in honor and memory of our fallen soldiers. And veterans, please enjoy a box of Girl Scout cookies, compliments to the Girl Scouts of Central Indiana, as you leave in the lobby. Pastor Davis.
Would you join me Gracious God, we lift to you these brave citizens, knowing you receive them into the larger life of unending joy. Let us not fear our duty as good citizens or recoil from the responsibility of being advocates of hope and mercy. Comfort all who mourn this day. Be with our brothers and sisters who face the perils of war. Grant them courage and strength, and grant us unending gratitude. Amen.